can't no more. I got the horses in the back, horse stock is attached. Head is matted black, got the bushes black to match. Riding on a horse, ha, you can whip your Porsche. I've been in the valley, you ain't been up off that porch. Now, nah, can't nobody tell me nothing.
It's Chache. What's going on, you guys? Chache back at you with another video. And today we're rocking out another Golem deck. I know we just had one last time, but we got another one. And actually, my friend, that one guy from my clan right here, but anyways, he's made this deck. He's gone on a pretty big run with it. That was his profile there. He's not the best player in the world, but he still said this deck was really solid. So I said, hey, I'll give it a try. So I'm in a tournament right now. It's the A tournament. This is what I've been doing because I'm too poor to afford gems. So somebody, if you want to sponsor me and give me some gems, I love you. Anyways, we are waiting for an opponent here, and once we get one, we'll go ahead and see ya on the other side. Alrighty, guys, here we go. Bucky from Warlords is our opponent here, but basically, this deck, he says, actually counters P.E.K.K.A. Spam, so it should be pretty nice if we verse P.E.K.K.A. Spam. Doesn't look like we're going to verse it off the bat here. Looks like a Hog Rider deck, maybe 2.6 with the Ice Spirit, who knows? Only one hit there, so that's pretty nice. Actually thought that was going to get a little more. I don't know why he didn't log earlier, but whatever. Guess he was trying to wait for some value. He still has the nice damage lead here. We're going to go ahead and just go Golem in the back since he is out of his Hog and he is playing 2.6. So we should be able to steamroll him here, honestly. If we just put a Furnace down like so, we'll go ahead and pull the Hog Rider over there. And the Ice Spirit, yeah, it's going to freeze my Furnace, but the Furnace won't get two waves anyways with the Hog Rider there. It should deny the Hog Rider, yeah, so there it is. We're going to go with a Witch here. It would have done really nice to have an Earthquake spell here, like last episode. But our Witch here is going to start spawning some Skellies, and Skellies are actually on that Musketeer there. The Musketeer has 1 HP. And doesn't seem like it wants to die. And it's actually, that was a beautiful log by him. That witch stays alive with 1 HP. And wow, the tower doesn't target our witch. That is unfortunate for him. And he's just kind of just spamming at this point, trying to get this defense in. We're going to try to go Barb Barrel to tank, but didn't tank quite as much. I was kind of just trying to cycle here. Because we know we're up a ton of elixir. And if we were back to a Golem, this game would just be about over. And he did just log, I think. I forget. If he did, that's nice. If he didn't, we're about to win the game right here, right now. All right, so here we go. He's going to defend with Skeletons. Honestly, at this point, he's just over-defending. We're getting huge positive Elixir trades. Yeah, we won't get a swing with that Mega Minion there, but that's okay. He's almost back to that Hog Rider. I think he needs two more cards. So we're just going to play another Witch here and then probably just poison it out or go in with a... I think we'll go Witch. We'll poison the Cannon. And there is the log fireball. So now we can go Lumberjack and we can go Goblin Gang here. He's obviously probably going to cycle back really fast. He's already two cards, three cards. He has log or fireball. I forget which one he had first. But anyways, Golem's going to get to the tower, get the punch. And there goes tower number one. Let's go ahead and go the other lane here with that Golem. We'll go with the Barb Barrel for defense here. Ice Spirit is going to get taken out. Barbarian will die. Our tower may die here. Yes, it will. Okay. So, good news for us, he just wasted his fireball, so we can go Witch. If he wants to kill our Witch, he can hit us again. Let's see what he's got here. We'll go Furnace here. Our Witch should turn and help out. Very nice. Okay, there's the fireball log. And that should be GG's. If I've ever seen GG's, it's GG's, fella. Alright, so Witch and everything else is going to get on the tower there. Interesting. We definitely finessed him. We could have taken a lot less damage, but it is beatdown. We'll take those little bit of damage for those nice positive elixir trades. We probably could have finessed him early on with that tower, but actually kept spamming, but didn't seem like that was the best idea. But hey guys, reading the live chat here, it seems like Chache says you need to subscribe to this video or I'm gonna steal your cat. Also below it, you can't see it because it's not there. I mean, wait, what? But it says if you don't have a cat, you're lying to me, and you actually have a cat. So I'll see you when the battle starts. But the battle started, and we're versing Zach from B-Tech E, boy. Let's get him. Thumbs up. Good luck. Nice little favorite emote. Claps. Gotta love the claps. We'll go Lumberjack here. Could have used the Goblin Gang, but I wasn't paying attention to the iPad. Okay. Lumberjack's gonna run down there. He's going to die. Let's go ahead and start a Witch. Witch is gonna get us a nice positive elixir trade, even though it's still a negative one. But technically, our Lumberjack got us a big positive elixir trade, so that means our dude got a positive elixir trade. We just accept the positive elixir trade, okay? Alright, thanks. Alright, so Witch is going down. The poison and everything will help take that out. If the wizard actually dies before... Okay, looks like our Witch is going to be able to spawn out some skeletons. So we're going to go Golem. Please lock on my Golem. Spawn some skellies. No! Feels bad. Okay, so now we got to go Goblin Gang here. So that's a little unfortunate. It's whatever, though. We'll still get a nice, healthy Golem and a couple Goblins over there to hopefully take out this Mini P.E.K.K.A. He's going to go with the Ghost as well. I haven't seen Ghost in a long time. That Mini P.E.K.K.A. should die. So I'm thinking I just go Fire Spirits here. With the furnace, we'll wait for it to connect. We'll go one tile over. So that way the fire spirits lock onto the ghost and don't die. And we should be able to get one wave out of here at least. We'll just chill. He goes giant, so we'll go witch in the back. You didn't see confirmed supercell water bottle, Kappa. Kappa, 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 Kappa. All right, Barb Barrel is being tanked for by the Lumberjack just for a hit there. It gets the job done. He's going to go with the Barb Barrel there. Everything's going to die. So now we can go ahead and go Goblin Gang because all he has probably now is a Ghost, which the Ghost will get obliterated with the Raged Goblins and Witches and all that good stuff. And there goes Tower number one. That is a lot of damage on that tower. Is that going to be a 3-crown? It may very well be. Close. The Witch is going to spawn a couple more Skellies. It locked on. Okay, so all we need is really this Golem death damage or two poisons and a Barb Barrel. Let's just start the poison, and we'll send in a Barb Barrel. Maybe he'll give it to us, probably won't, but we'll see. Looks like he gave it to us. Dab it on them, fools. All right, boys. This last game, we got to go sweaty, Super Saiyan sweats. Sunglass sweaty. That's what we got to do. I want to play that number one player. That'd be pretty nice. So we'll see you in the game when we go Super Saiyan sweat mode. Alrighty, boys, reversing some Asian dude 0071. He's got 7 wins. We gotta go Super Saiyan sweat mode on these fools. The sunglasses are on. This is the sweaty sunglasses. We've never lost with our sweaty sunglasses on. Alright. Super glue. Okay, snowballs, we'll go Goblin Gang at the bridge. See if he's got another spell. Barbs? Take it out, but I think my witch is gonna be OP and just take it out because witch is pretty good right now. Hasn't found a very nice deck competitively quite yet. We could have golem there, but I don't know exactly what deck he's playing, so we're gonna play it safe and just poison. He's gonna barb rail there, well played. But that musketeer should sit in the poison because of the skellies. Yeah, we'll be alright. Furnace, and also. Gotta hit him with it. All right, he's going to RG, so he does have RGesus. We're gonna hit him with the Barb Barrel here. Should kill out those fire spirits. Go for that furnace, and our Lumberjack will take it all out before it even gets a chance to hit a tower there. So, really nice start. We gotta go with another witch in the back here. Probably could have put it in the rage and would have been a little better, but please don't spawn furnace. Yeah, there we go, boys. All right, he's coming with the snowball. Not very good snowball. The skeletons didn't spawn. Maybe he mistimed it. But that's okay. Okay, let's hit him with it. Let's go. Come on, witch. Stay behind. Skeletons! No! It didn't tank, but that's okay. We got a lot of skeletons, and he wasted both of his spells, so this should be tower right there. One skeleton survives. Let's go Goblin Gang just to 100,000% confirm that we're going to get this tower. Spear Goblin's going to go ahead and take out that. I'm not sure why all my goblins died or how they died, but whatever. Still going to take out the tower there. So a very nice start to the game. We'll go Mega Man in the same lane here, and we got to give him the nice little sunglasses. All right, here we go. Lumberjack's going down. We're gonna go furnace as well. That was a kind of a bad furnace, but also a good furnace. The placement was meh. We'll go Barb Barrel here. We basically won this game. There's no way he has only gotten, like, chip damage from a snowball this entire game. So it's interesting. But hopefully you guys learned a thing or two about this deck. I haven't play tested it a whole lot, but by the little bit that I play tested the couple games, like I played probably like 10 games with it. It's been pretty nice. Now, should we let him take our towers so that way we can three crown him? I probably shouldn't have went this lane if I was trying to do that, but we're going to let him take a tower. If he wants to take it, he can take it, all right? That'll be our little present to him. All right, Barbarella's going to swipe up here, kill everything. He may or may not take our tower there, but we want to take his tower. He will take our tower there. And we're just going to put a furnace in his face as the goodbye present, right? Because now we got to give him the sunglasses, boys. Because alrighty, boys. Well, that is going to do it for today's episode. If you guys did enjoy, make sure to hit that like button. Otherwise, my sweaty sunglasses will find you and your cat. I will steal it. I'll add to my cat collection. Just kidding, I don't have a cat collection. Don't sue me, please. I'll see you guys in the next video. If you guys have any deck suggestions you guys want to see, maybe a troll episode where you guys throw me the worst decks possible, I try to win, let me know and I'll give it a shot. I'll see you guys next time. Thanks for watching. Peace.